inspire to go higher. There's nobody like us. You can put it all on the prizes.
How do we make cities smarter? What kind of technologies are we using to make the subway run faster, to keep the water clean, to prevent flooding? One of our programs is Innovation, Entrepreneurship, and the Science of Smart Cities, ieSoSC. This is a more advanced version of our middle school program, Science of Smart Cities, working with high school students in ieSoSC to take some of those smart cities concepts and advance them with techniques from innovation and entrepreneurship. So not just studying how to code and build a circuit and use sensors to take data from the environment around you, but going the next step with your idea and find out if this can be a successful venture.
So ieSoSC is kind of like marketing and technology use at the same time. Most of our instructors are masters in management of technology. So we learned how to use Arduino and Cduino-based programming, so coding with like C#, and basically working with sensors mainly. So that's what most of our projects are about. It's kind of a creative program in a way. We're allowed to do kind of whatever we want with the sensors, just as long as we are solving a real world issue.
We were introduced to this group of fantastic students who have independently come up with a concept and a prototype for a flood sensing system. And we are just intrigued to learn more about the thoughts they've had and the approaches they've taken to this problem, because it's a big one.
New York City and a lot of other regions around the world are experiencing flooding at an increased frequency because of climate change. And so certain storms that used to be somewhat manageable are becoming more intense, which is beyond what our drainage systems can handle. So that's why we started this project. What FloodNet is we're developing a network of sensors that measure water level on the streets. And so instead of just having information that says there's a flood or not, we actually have quantitative information on the profile of that flood.
We're analyzing data given to us, and we're saying, what does this data tell us? Which areas are most affected by flooding, and how do we measure that? We want to assess where is the top priority, and how do you decide the top priority in need of a flood sensor?
I was really excited to meet them, and I think it was really cool to have them like talk about our project and give us advice, and not only that, but tell us that our ways of thinking were good, and like giving us the rundown of how our project can be improved.
I think it's very interesting, and I like how they gave us like advice on finances and stuff like that. So for us, we only have like a prototype, so I think it's very interesting to hear what they think and how we could advance our project in the future.